Ions are formed when an atom gives away or takes electrons, an activity that shifts the delicate balance between the protons in the nucleus and outer electrons. When two oppositely charged ions attract, they form what is known as an ionic bond. Since charge-containing ions are involved in bonding, ionic bonds are strong bonds. The bond energy range from 400 to 4000 kilojoules per mole, which means an ionic bond can only break when this much energy is supplied. It is pretty high compared to other bond types, so such ionic compounds have high melting and boiling points. Such an ionic bond formation is seen between a metal and a non-metal. Another easiest way to spot an ionic bond is to look for the combining atom's electronegativity difference. If the difference is above 1.7, the bond type is definitely ionic. In the solid state, the ions hold definite positions to form crystal structures. However, in the solution state, the ions are mobile, proven by their electrical and heat conductivity. Covalent bond. When two atoms do not want to gain or lose their electrons, but still lack an octet electronic configuration in their outermost shell for stability, they share electrons to form a covalent bond. The strength of a covalent bond is weaker than ionic and requires 150 to 1100 kilojoules per mole of energy for breakage. Covalently bonded compounds have low melting and boiling points compared to ionic, where the energy input is high. Nonmetals engage in covalent bond formation, and such atoms have their electronegativity difference below 1.7. Since the atoms are not free but linked in covalent bonds to form molecules, such molecules are not good conductors of heat and electricity. Covalent compounds are neutral and they do not have any charges exposed like ions. However, the bond's electron distribution between two atoms may get uneven, such that one atom may have a higher bond electron density than the other, creating poles. Such partial charge separation is denoted by delta positive and negative signs at the poles and results in the polarity of covalent compounds. Metallic bond. The metallic bond is an attractive bond between metal atoms responsible for metal's appearance, shape, malleability and ductility. Metal atoms have a large size. When a nucleus of such a large atom cannot effectively hold its outermost valence electrons, the electrons detach and delocalize. The attraction between many such positive ions and a delocalized sea of electrons forms metallic bonds. The delocalized electron in metals make them an excellent conductor of electricity. The metallic bond strength of 68 to 800 kilojoules per mole lies between covalent and van der Waal strength. The metals have high melting and boiling points. Van der Waal forces. They are intermolecular forces of attraction occurring between covalent molecules. It is of three types based on the nature of interacting covalent molecules: polar-polar, nonpolar-nonpolar, or polar-nonpolar interactions. Using van der Waal forces, molecules closely associate or pack together without forming any chemical bond. Since they are non-bond-forming attractive interactions, van der Waal forces are distance-dependent. The farther the molecules, the weaker the interaction. Van der Waal forces are weak interactions, however, they operate universally in all atoms and molecules. The collective interaction between atoms is strong enough to affect the physical properties of melting point and boiling point. The molecules that associate using van der Waal forces are covalent molecules or inert atoms. Therefore, they are non-conductors of heat and electricity. For side-by-side comparison, click the link below, which will take you to curlyarrows.com. For more such content, subscribe to Learn Chemistry with Sibi.